Imagine waking up one morning and you're a completely different person. You can't control yourself, you say bad words, you can't stop touching other people, and you have a weird desires. Let me tell you the story of Phineas Gage. On September 13, 1848, the 25-year-old Phineas Gage, he was a normal, polite, and disciplined man. He was a foreman working on a railroad in Cavendish, and he was pinning holes and blasting black rocks. While he was packing the hole with sand, his 13-pound tamping iron rod sparked the hole and detonated the gunpowder. Then his rod, which is 3 feet and 7 inches, went directly through his head, went from his left cheek to behind his left eye, went through his brain and exited through the middle of his head and landed 30 yards, which is about 25 meters away. Wow, this was a big trauma for him. Miraculously, he did survive this trauma and he was able to walk a few minutes later. But since the accident, Phineas Gage became a completely different person. He was impulsive, inappropriate, saying bad words, and not able to complete his daily tasks. His friend described him as, quote, no longer Gage. It's interesting that our best understanding of the brain function came from those unfortunate accidents that led to brain damage. It's like knowing which switch for which light when the light is no longer working. The frontal lobe, especially the prefrontal cortex, makes who we are and our personality, and it is in a very vulnerable location in the front of the head. So people, when they have accidents, the brain usually smacks against this very rigid skull, and that causes lots of damage after the accident. It's like seeing a child next to you eating an ice cream and you want this ice cream so badly. Then the frontal lobe kicks in. No, it's inappropriate, don't do it. But if you don't have the frontal lobe, you just grab it, and this is like being impulsive. So the frontal lobe is crucial in almost all of the psychiatric conditions. Patients with ADHD have decreased frontal lobe functions of multitasking and task completion. Patients with anxiety and depression also have decreased frontal lobe control over the emotion areas. For example, normal daily activity like riding a bus all of a sudden becomes an excessive worry and something that you could not handle. The massive land of the frontal lobe, which is considered the largest part of the brain, has many other functions. An ancient Greek physician, Hippocrates, noted that when soldiers are hit on the right side of the brain, they have left-sided weakness. This is interesting that the right side of the brain controls the left side of the body, and the left side of the brain controls the right side of the body. The left and right story does not end on that. The left side of the brain controls the language production. You speak through your left side of the brain, and the same side on the other side is responsible for emotional processing and understanding others' emotions and adding emotions to your own speech. That's cool, huh? Let's go back to our friend. Phineas Gage did recover and was able to hold a job in Chile and California and was normal afterwards. This gives a hope for people with brain damage and accident that things can recover and be normal after some time. However, he did develop epilepsy from that scar in his brain. 11 years later, at the age of 36, Phineas Gage had seizures in the day and night, and they did not stop, and that is called status epilepticus, and he died because of that. So he did technically die because of his accident. And to learn more about epilepsy and seizures, you can see these videos, and see you in the next one.